Post this to our YouTube page. Welcome in, everybody. It's just about 3 o'clock, so we're going to go ahead and get started. My name is Megan Nair, and I'm here from Emory's Cognitive Empowerment Program. It's our weekly webinar where we offer engaging programming from all of our service providers here at CEP on topics related to mild cognitive impairment. And the topics range from everything from technology to innovation, different lifestyle interventions and environment. And these community live virtual events are open to all members of the community. That includes people who are diagnosed with MCI or dementia, care partners, and clinicians. And our programming is usually a selection of our service providers here at CEP. We've got an amazing group of people who do cognitive training, physical activities, nutrition, support groups, and all of the things that really are meant to build community around those folks and members of their family who are experiencing memory loss. What we do know, what research has proven time and time again, is that regular exercise of any intensity, even simple stretching and balance moves, can protect the brain health of older adults with mild cognitive impairment. If you watch this year's Alzheimer's Association International Conference, it was really the whole talk of the whole conference, is that it doesn't even require heavy, sweaty cardio workouts, but even simple stretching and balance moves can be that big help, that big support to kind of turn around or shift the outcome of diagnosis. Researchers found that in older adults who engage in either moderate or high intensity aerobic training, or even low intensity stretching, balance, and range of motion exercises, for 12 months showed no decline in their baseline cognitive function. So keep that in mind as you've been thinking about these workouts and why you want to participate in these workouts. Keep in mind that making a commitment to them over the course of the year can have a really big impact on your cognitive function. And this week, we're so blessed. We've got Tina Rasheed, one of my favorite instructors from the program. Tina is coming to us with a really wide, broad, expansive range in her background in Tai Chi and Qigong. She's been teaching for over 30 years, everywhere from Emory to Spelman, all over the country. And we're so excited to have her here today. She's been leading the Tai Chi program for the past 2 years at the Cognitive Empowerment Program. And she's truly transformed all of our members into Tai Chi players. And you'll get a little taste of that this week. We've got some forms and movements that she's put together to share with us this week. And we're going to play a little bit of music in the background. Let us know if the music is too loud at any point in time. Let us know in the chat if you have any questions during our session. But otherwise, welcome, Tina. It's so good to see you this week.
Hi, Maren. How are you, Megan?
I'm doing well.
Good.
And anything, I was kind of curious, as far as teaching at CEP goes, what's been your favorite part of teaching students here at CEP?
I think what you mentioned, Megan, is really my favorite part, the transformation. You know, people come to Tai Chi, it may or may not be something that they're familiar with. They may have heard different things about Tai Chi. There's this mysticism that, unfortunately surrounds it. But when I see that they train for, a short period of time and how they really see the benefit of what they're doing and completely change their understanding of Tai Chi, their focus. So that's my favorite part, when the light bulb goes on.
And what's really special about Tina is that she's not just a master in Tai Chi, but she's also got a really long, over a 26-year career in public health as a researcher at Morehouse School of Medicine. And she really brings that mission to her work at CEP to kind of bridge this gap between health disparity, martial arts, kind of being this technique of really committing to your practice to promote health and prevent disease. So thank you so much, Tina, for being here. I'm going to go ahead and pass it over and let her share Tai Chi, this really beautiful composition of slow, deliberate movements that will help clarify your deep breathing, your mental focus, and also your physical health and emotional health as well. So Tina, go ahead.
Okay, thank you, Megan. Thanks again. And welcome, everyone. Welcome returning Tai Chi players. Welcome new Tai Chi players. And I just want to let you know that the way we learn in here is simply by following. I love to share this because everybody can do it. You know, you do it to the extent which your body can do it. So let's go ahead and get started. The three things that you want to keep in mind, what a wonderful day to chi up, because the rain slows the mind down so that the mind and the body can connect. And the three things that you want to keep in mind as we go through our movements, our postures, is that you want to breathe. Okay, a lot of times when we're focusing externally, we have the habit of holding our breath. So as you move, you want to coordinate breath and movement so they don't fight, so that you can move with ease. Whatever direction we move in, we always want to balance that by moving in the opposite direction as well. Whatever we do on one side of the body, again, for balance, we want to do on the opposite. So we're moving, we're breathing. It's the breath that moves the blood. It's the blood that moves the energy. So if you think about the body like a straw, if your straw is crushed, energy can't move through it. So as we move, as we breathe, we open up our straw so that the energy can move like the river through the body to wherever the body needs it. So as you move, you begin to see how in every movement, we focus on a particular area, but not only just on that area, the whole body is connected. So in order to easily relax and move a particular area of the body, you've got to relax all adjacent areas as well. So as we circle the knees, pushing into the earth to create the momentum, not stressing our large external muscles, we just simply push down and allow the knees to circle. Now, in order to allow the knees to circle comfortably, we've got to relax the hips and the hip socket. We've got to relax the glutes. Begin to see how by using your internal focus, you can see how everything is connected. So we're breathing. We're focusing. And go ahead and take the deep cleansing breath in through the nose, like sipping water through a straw, and let the body expand like the balloon. And as we exhale, let's go the other way. Pushing down, using our focus. Remember, wherever the mind goes, the energy goes. So we want to focus internally to allow the muscles, tendons, and ligaments to yield, to give as we move. We move slowly so that we can achieve balance in our movement. Anytime we feel unbalanced, we have a tendency to tighten up. So we want to move only as fast as we can breathe comfortably and feel balance. So let's go ahead and let the torso hang forward. Knees soft, feet open. Loose to the fingertips, the chin resting on the chest. Letting gravity assist, we're gonna push into the earth. Continue to lean like the puppet. And use your internal focus to stack the vertebrae, one on top of the other. Don't miss any. All the way up through the shoulders, up through the neck, to the point where the skull connects with the spine. All right. Hands on the hips. Shifting the weight, relaxing the waist again, creating the momentum by pushing into the earth. We're breathing. We're feeling for focus, feeling our way through each movement, feeling for focus so that we don't tighten, feeling for balance, and breathing. So we're like the marble on a saucer. If you tilt the saucer, the marble rolls. Relaxing the hips, the glutes, the abdomen is soft, like the baby's. Begin to notice where you have a tendency to hold tension. Whether it's clamping the jaw, shrugging the shoulders, holding the tightness in the abdomen or chest, or locking the legs. So let's go ahead and we're going to circle back to center. We're going to take the deep cleansing breath. And exhaling, let's go the opposite direction. I always say breathe into the soles of the feet. And in the process, we let the body expand on all sides like the balloon. So as we breathe, as we shift, just breathe however the body needs to. Letting the breath support the movement. But when we do the deep breaths, we want to breathe deep past the bottom of the lungs. And let's go ahead and circle to center. And again, torso hanging like the rag doll, loose to the fingertips, opening up our energy channels as we push up. Our energy channels are meridians that carry the energy to where it's needed. Let's continue. We're going to shift the weight. Loose to the fingertips, raise the heel. I'm going to move back a little so you can see my feet. Raise the heel, relax the hip and groin. Just like we're shaking off any excess tension that we've been holding. So often we hold tension and we're not even aware of it. We hold tension out of habit. But it's good to remind yourself that you have a choice to release tension. Breathing as you move, and gradually, let's come back to center. And just like allowing the hands to rest on the dantian, the area 2 inches below the navel. For women, left palm over right. As we stand comfortably, we want to let the knees be soft. The feet open. Our feet are our foundation, our balance. We want to let them open like the duck's feet. Let the tip of the coccyx tuck forward, releasing the tension from the lower back as if you're sitting on a high stool. Allow the crown to face the heavens, crown towards the heavens, not rigidly so, but just naturally so. And take a few seconds to notice the movement of the qi internally. Tai Chi being an internal exercise, the most important aspect of what we're doing is what's happening inside. So focus on the feeling, however qi presents to you. As we focus on the feeling, we cultivate it, we make it bigger, we magnify. And let the arms float down. Let's continue our warm-up. We're going to space the feet, shift the weight, and sinking down as we shift, yielding. Let the spine turn. Drop the shoulder. Look behind as the palms face heaven and earth. Now push into the full side, always taking the time to breathe in. Shifting the weight, sinking down, extending up, letting the rib cage open, spine twist. Using our internal focus, we let the movement complete itself until we feel the change of the energy. So breathing in to breathe out. Relax the muscles underneath the arm. And continue at your own pace, pushing down to create momentum, breathing in, feeling for balance, never overextending, never underextending. We seek the middle way, the point at which any further there would be no balance. Pushing down one last time, breathing in, breathing out as we shift. And pushing down, let's come back to center. Arms floating up, tip of the fingers to heaven, knees soft, and let the arms float down and the head float forward. Relax the jaw. Let the head hang as if you couldn't pick it up if you wanted to. Arms like ropes hanging off the shoulder. Allow gravity again to assist. Always yielding. So let's go ahead and we're going to shift the weight. This time we're going to allow the head to roll like a marble in a slot. Ear towards the shoulder, no further. And push down on the floor, and let's, as the head rolls, we transfer the weight, empty to full. We want to go only as far as the shoulder because we want to be very careful about the vertebrae in the neck, very easy to damage. Shifting the weight. We feel that stretch from the back of the ear to the tips of the fingers. Feel the energy moving. Opening up the pathway. Always aware of where the mind is. And this time, let's go ahead and roll back to center. Head hanging, arms loose. We're going to push into the earth and let the arms float up. As if floating on water, We're going to embrace the energy from above and allow it to float down over the body like warm oil. Stay engaged with the feeling as it moves down over the torso, over the hips, down the legs to fill up our shoes, feet are open, crown to heaven, so that we can access the energy coming from above, feet are open, to access the energy from that's coming from below. And all we have to do is stand supported by these two forces, standing with ease. And just focus on the feeling as the chi continues to move out from the center, through the legs, the hands, through the arms, through the hands, through the legs, through the feet. And all we have to do is breathe, being soft inside and loose outside. And float down. Okay, let's go ahead and shift. And we're going to pivot on the heel and shift towards the toe, looking out. Transfer the weight fully so that you can root to the heel of the other foot. Whatever leg is forward, that's the arm on top. So we want to put the oar in the water. As we shift forward, naturally gravity says sink down. We push down, we shift back, sinking down. Arms float up, pushing into the back leg. Transferring the weight forward, torso turning. We're rowing the boat. Again, arms are like ropes hanging off the shoulder. So just breathe. You're like the rocking chair. The momentum brings us one direction. And push down, sink down, lower your center of gravity so that you can feel the balance. Arms are loose as we sit back, relaxing the shoulders to float up. Torso turns. Arms never move on their own accord. We're patient, allowing the middle circle to turn and allowing the upper circle, the shoulders, the arms to follow. Now, even as we shift in this simple movement, we want to relax and open the soles of the feet so we can massage the acupressure, acupuncture points, and the soles of the feet, stimulating and nourishing the organs and systems. Again, opening up the energy channels. All right, and this time as we shift forward, let's put the oar in the water and looking out, seeking balance. Let's step forward to root whatever leg, arms on top, back foot. Make sure it's turned so that you can protect your knee. So notice the synchronizing, the coordination of the upper and the lower. Just let it happen. Feeling our way again through each movement. Not using force. Moving as if moving through water, as if we were immersed in a big vat of salt water. Pushing down, we sink down, legs stretching. Shifting forward, sink down, legs stretching. Breathing. Enjoying the release of tension as we open up the meridians, as we allow the legs, the hips, the waist. The entire body is engaged in each movement. So let's go ahead. We're going to shift forward. And this time we're going to put the oar in the water. And again, feeling for balance. Bring the momentum forward, the step up, the float down. And just take a few seconds standing comfortably, which means we have our feet open like the ducks. Knees are soft. We let the tip of the coccyx tuck forward, releasing the tension from the lower back, as if we were sitting on a high stool. Crown towards the heaven, tongue resting on the roof of the mouth, naturally. Relaxing the jaw. And again, let's just take a few seconds to cultivate the energy. We feel the energy getting even stronger, moving even more rapidly. And float down. So there are a lot of different Qigong forms. We've done a few during CEP Live. But today I'd like to focus on the eight silk brocade. Use the term Qigong and Tai Chi kind of interchangeably because Tai Chi is Qigong. Qigong translated means breath work. And at the root of this, both of these internal exercises is the breath. So as we go through the eight silk brocade, always monitor your body to make sure that you're breathing, not holding the breath as you participate, okay? So standing comfortably, feet open, knees soft, arms loose, crown to heaven, looking out as if we're looking at the perimeter of the forest. Okay, let's go ahead and take the deep cleansing breath. And exhaling, we're going to sink into the legs as if they were rubber, transfer the weight, and separate the feet, rooting to the inside of the heel. Okay, and our first exercise is called Two Arms Hold Up the Sky. So we're going to gently rock forward. Arms float up, again, loose to the fingertips, as if moving through water. Knees soften, arms slow down. Arms float up. Palms cross. We're going to lean back. Push down to come back to a vertical position and float down. Okay, now let's coordinate the breath with this. As the arms float up, we're going to breathe in. Body expanding. As the arms float down, we breathe out. Breathing out fully. Now don't drop the energy. Let's just make it a continuous movement. Arms float up. We breathe in. Looking at the heavens, we breathe out. Now don't pull up with the back. Push into the earth. Become vertical. We breathe in. And arms float down. We breathe out. In. Moving like the train on the track and out. and in. And out. And in. And out. All right. Two arms hold up the sky. So what Tai Chi and Qigong presents, it enables us to become more acquainted with energy, not only the energy that moves through us, but the energy that surrounds us. Connecting, becoming very intentional about our movements. All right. So as we move, the mind is like the slippery fish. We'll have it one place, but it might go somewhere else. So we always want to bring the mind back. It's the natural inclination of the mind to be engaged with something. So we allow the mind to engage with the feeling and the movement, not thinking about other things. The mind can't be in two places at one time. All right, so let's do this one last time. Relaxing, breathing in. And out. And in. And out. Pushing down and in. And out. So by engaging the mind, we become more familiar with the feeling of the energy, all right? So as we move, we don't want to just drop the energy. We want to show the continuity of the movement. So that as my hands float down, like the train on the track, they continue so that it looks like one long movement from beginning to end. Let's go on to another one of the brocades. Standing comfortably. Comfortably, legs should be about shoulder width apart, but always find your point of balance. If you feel balance, then you can stand comfortably. This is called dropping the post. So what we're going to do is we're going to roll to the balls of the feet, lifting the heels, and then we're going to drop. Now, the important thing is when you drop the heels that you allow the body to be completely loose. It's like shaking out a wrinkled garment, all right? When the heels drop, the body will, in particular, the vertebrae of the spine can realign. So we're just trying to shake the body out. So let's go ahead. As we roll to the balls of the feet, let's breathe in. And out, in, loose, out, and in, and out, and in, and drop. And one last time, breathing in, and out. Okay, shaking the body out, dropping the post. So let's go ahead and move to our next of the eight slip brocade. It's called gazing at the hand. So we want to, on this particular exercise, transfer the weight to space the feet just a little bit wider. And as we shift, arms float up. One floats back behind the back of the hand resting on the kidney. The other floats forward, the float, and we're going to look at the back of the hands. And pushing into the earth, eyes never leave the hand from this point on. As the hand floats out, and then we're going to turn the hand to look at the palm, pushing down, and watch this beautiful hand as it floats out. Now, we don't want our arm out stiff, keeping the energy from moving. Relax the elbow. So as the hand floats out, the other floats up. We're going to look at the back of both hands and push down, hands floating, breathing. And at this point, we're going to wrap the other kidney. Now let's show the continuity in this by pushing at down and arm floating. Relax the hips, let the spine twist. And we're breathing. Eyes never leave the hand. Hands float up. And we push. Relax the shoulders, elbows. Relax and down. And we wrap. And continue back and forth at your own pace. Now notice as we cross our center of gravity, naturally, unless we fight, naturally we sink down, which means we've got to let the hips, the groin, the glutes, the lower back, all yield. Arms floating as if floating on water. Nothing in sight but the hands. Always breathing. Gazing at the hand. Arm floating. And this time, as we shift the weight, let's bring the arm back to center to float down. And take a few seconds and let's cultivate the energy, standing comfortably. Sitting on the high stool, feet open. And as you stand, just monitor the body to make sure you haven't gone back to old habits of holding tension in the jaw, in the shoulder, in the neck. You need to rearrange, shake it out. Stomach is soft. When we see a baby sleeping on its back, we see the stomach expanding and contracting. Our stomach should be just that soft, not forcing the expansion and contraction, just naturally. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on to our next of the eight silk brocade. This is one of my favorites. This is called pulling the bow, shooting the arrow. So if you've ever been involved in archery, you know the force of pulling back and pushing forward at the same time. Now, as we do this in this particular movement, we want to let the chest yield, open, shoulders relaxed, and open up the chest, upper back. All right. So one of the essentials of Tai Chi is empty to full. So we've been using it all along. We transfer the weight, pushing into the earth to create the momentum. All right. So we want to always push into the earth. We don't want to stress or use force. So standing comfortably, let's go ahead and take the deep cleansing breath. And as we exhale, let's sink into the legs. Hanging like a puppet on a string. Transfer the weight to separate, root to the inside of the heel. And this time as we shift the weight, this arm is going to float up It doesn't matter left or right, whatever direction. You can mirror me. And we're going to let the arm float back to pull the arrow out of the sheath on the shoulder. Pull it up and out. And as we circle to center, it's as if both of the hands were connected by a string. As we face forward, palms turn out, and we follow the fingers as we pull the bow and release the arrow, making our momentum as the arm drops, move in the opposite direction so that we can pull the arrow from the opposite shoulder. As we come to center, hand circle, we breathe in, following the fingers, and breathe out as the arrow flies. Pushing into the earth, let the hips stretch, the legs stretch, and we push down to pull up. Breathing in, lower your center of gravity so you can feel the balance to really pull the bow, and breathe out. Shifting, arms floating down, pulling the torso to the other side. We don't ever have to use force. Soles of the feet open, we have our balance. Breathing in. And ha, let it go. Relaxing the hip. And this time, as we pull the arrow, let's come back to center to float down. Okay, from standing comfortably, we're next going to go into what's called gazing at the far heel. And the most important aspect of what we're doing is what is happening inside. So we need to maintain our focus so we can be vigilant in letting the muscles, tendons, and ligaments give. Okay, so arms float up. And exhaling. And we look for the far heel. As the palms float up and push down. Torso turns, arms float up. And as we exhale, arms float down to float up, feet open, relax that hip, let the side open. And breathe in. And breathe out. Relax the glutes, the hips. Legs soft, looking for the far heel. And again, breathing in, loose to the fingertips. And breathing out. Arms float up. Pushing down into the earth to create the momentum to come to the other side, to the center, and sinking down, feet open. Feel for balance. Pushing down, relax the shoulders, relax the neck, head hanging. Notice what all is involved in that movement. and push down. Letting the hips, notice the movement, let the hips yield. And sink down, push down. And push down, and body unwinding back to the center. And take a few seconds and just stand comfortably. I hope your diligence paid off. So just stand and cultivate the energy. And arms flow down, smelling the rose. But as we go through this, I want you to think of your favorite smell. And as the palm floats up, I want you to inhale and imagine that smell. And as the arm continues to float, we exhale and share that smell with the universe. And at this point, and the eyes never leave the hand as the palm turns out to float down, to float back to center. Breathing in your favorite smell. Exhaling, eyes on the hand, all the way. As it circles down, back to the center. And out. Ah, whatever your favorite smell is. Eyes never leaving the hand. Take it in, eyes on the hand, and sharing it. Eyes on the hand as it floats up. As it turns out, as it floats down, all the way back to center. And one last time, breathing in. Eyes never leave. Breathe out. Relax the neck as you circle down, back to center. And one last time. And out. And back to center. And our hands float down. Okay. Our next exercise involves the feet a little bit more, so make sure you have the room. This is called tense and punch. So as we transfer the weight, the arm floats up. The other arm floats up to meet it. We transfer fully so we can root forward to roll from heel to toe. The whole body delivers the punch. Now open the hand and sit back, legs stretching, sinking down. Feel for balance. Arms circle back. We step back and we block. Transfer the weight fully. Arms extended to assist with balance, to root, to shift. All of the power coming from the dantian. And sit back. Arms circle back. Transfer the weight to step, to transfer, to root, to shift. Relax the glutes, lower back. Feel the stretch throughout the whole body, opening up the meridians. Moving only as fast as you in your body can feel balanced. Loose to the fingertips. Sit back. Naturally, we sink down. Arms circle. We block. Torso turning. We transfer to root. Shifting forward, we sink down. Sitting back, gravity demands that we release. Breathing, always breathing. Root to shift. Sit back. Arms are like the tightrope walker's wand, assisting with balance, to step back, to float down. Take a few seconds. Really feel the chi moving, like a vibration, a warmth, a tingling, however it may present, a feeling of being more alive. And float down. So our last posture is called curve back. So we're going to shift the weight to separate the feet. One arm floats forward as the torso turns. The other floats back. We're always looking forward though. And shifting the weight, allowing the torso to turn, palms pass. One arm circles down, the other circles out. Relax the hips, the lower back, curve back, looking forward. From a more martial perspective, what we're doing is we're pushing our opponent away and preparing for his return and pushing him away again. It's like pulling taffy. Transferring the weight from one side to the other as we breathe. As the arms are extended, the palms are facing the heavens. And this time, as we come back to center, palms face and float down. Standing comfortably. Let's end with a short breathing exercise called wave breathing. If you think about the waves of the ocean, they go out, they come in on their own accord. Nothing tells the waves when to stop. So as we stand comfortably, hands on the dantian, we're going to, again, breathe into the soles of the feet, let the body expand as the arms float out, filling up to the top of the lungs and exhaling. The waves come back and relax, breathing in. And let it go. Moving through water. Breathing in through the nose, like sipping water through a straw. And gradually releasing. Gradual in, gradual out. Breathing in and let it go. Every time we exhale is the opportunity to release tension. So, having done our postures, we've brought the energy to the surface of the body. So before we leave, we want to seal it in the body. So standing comfortably, we want to place the hands on the dantian. And using our inner focus, we feel the energy rise up through the torso, through the chest, across the shoulders, down the arms, over the hands, through the fingers, where wrists come together to create the lotus blossom that floats up and over the back of the head, down the neck, over the shoulders, to the upper back. Down the back, over the lower back, over the hips, down the back of the legs, to the heels, around the foot. Palms touching all the time, up the front of the legs, to the dantian. I'm going to do this two more times, focusing on feeling, breath. Maintaining our focus. Always breathing, sealing, touching. To seal the energy in the legs. And one last time.
moving the energy through the body, sharing it. Back to the center, palms over the dantian, standing comfortably. We start with the small circle, and we let that small circle gradually expand, touching or not touching. Until it encompasses the entire abdomen. And then we're going to let that large circle, going in the opposite direction, gradually contract, stomach soft, always breathing. Until we find the palms back where we began. And resting the palms on the dantian, that area 2 inches below the navel, we're going to feed the energy into the body's energy vault. Stomach soft and moving, feet open. And just enjoy the movement. And arms float down, the float up. And we're going to bring the energy to the palms. And push down. Arms circle up, knees soften, palms to heaven, looking up, stomach soft. And we're going to breathe, feeling the body expanding and contracting. And shift the weight, feet together. And I salute you for being here with me today. It's always my pleasure. I'm Tina Rasheed, and I'll see you next month. Hope you feel great.